If you are visiting our channel for the first time, please subscribe first to get the latest updates.
Our today's topic is Venn diagram representation of De Morgan's law. In our previous lecture, we have seen the proof of the De Morgan's law. Now, the mathematical representation of De Morgan's law is A union B whole complement, A complement intersection B complement, and A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. So, first we will take the form 1, that is this one, and then we will take the form 2 for forming the for the Venn diagram representation of the De Morgan's law. So, we will start with the form 1 and take its left hand side on one side and the right hand side on the other. And let's start how you can form the Venn diagram. So, for A union B whole complement, we have to break this into two parts. One is A union B. First, we have to find the Venn diagram of A union B. Then, we will find diagram of A union B whole complement, that is equals to U minus A union B. So, let's see how you can form the Venn diagram of this form, of this side. For that purpose, we will first form a Venn diagram like this, where this is the universal set. So, I'll write the universal set U here, and the two sets are A and B. So, I'll write them as like this. This is A and this is B. Now, for A union B, according to the Venn diagram, according to the concept of A union B, in A union B, all the elements of A and B are included. So, we can say that the area that will be included in the Venn diagram of A union B will be this one, in which all the elements of A and B will be included. So, this is basically A union B. Now, what is U minus A union B? That is A union B whole complement. Let's see. First, I'll draw the universal set. This is the universal set. And we have the two sets A and B. This is A and this is B. And this is the universal set. Now, A union B whole complement. How we can represent the A union B whole complement? It will be U minus A union B. It means you have to subtract the A union B from the universal set. It means if I subtract A union B, then I have to subtract the A and B altogether. So, U minus A union B will be this portion. The portion other than A and B will be the complement of A union B. So, this is actually the A union B whole complement. A union B whole complement. As I have subtracted A union B altogether from the universal set, and we are left with the this shaded portion. This is the A union B whole complement. Now, let's take the right hand side, where we have A complement intersection B complement. Here we will have three parts, because first we find A complement, then B complement, and then their intersection. So, I'll write as A complement, B complement, and then A complement intersection B complement. Now, keep this mind, it should be equal to A union B whole complement. So, let's draw it as how will be the graph of A complement. This is the universal set. These are the two sets A and B. Okay, then A complement means U minus A. It means I have to subtract the portion of A from the whole set. So, we have to subtract the A from the whole portion. So, I'll shade the portion. U minus A is we have to subtract the A. So, the portion will be left inside. Now, keep this in mind. In A complement, the intersection portion of A and B will not be included. That means that as we have subtracting the A, so we have to subtract the all elements of A that will also include in the intersection. So, we will take A complement like this. Now, let's see what is B complement. These are the two sets A and B. This is universal set A and B. Now, let's shade the portion that will include, that will be B complement. So, B complement is U minus B. You have to subtract the B from the whole set. So, let's shade the portion that will represent U minus B. So, this is the portion of U minus B. Now, let's see what will be the intersection of A complement and B complement. This is A, this is B, this is universal set. So, A complement intersection B complement is the common portion of A complement and B complement. So, it is clear from here that the common portion of A complement and B complement is the universal set only. So, we can we can shade the portion as like this. This is the only common portion of A intersection, A complement intersection, B complement. As this is A and this is B. So A intersection, A complement intersection, B complement is this. Now it is clear that the Venn diagram of A union B whole complement and A complement intersection B is the same. So this is the same as like this. So we have proved both the right hand side, both the left hand side and the right hand side. Now this was the Venn diagram representation of the of this form of the De Morgan's law. Now let's see how you can represent this of the De Morgan's law on the Venn diagram. We have, first we will write the form as A intersection B whole complement is equals to A complement union B complement. So on one side I'll write A intersection B whole complement, and on the other side I'll write A complement union B complement. So let's start drawing it. As we have already seen how you can draw the De Morgan's law. So A intersection B whole complement can be drawn as, first we will draw the universal set in which we have A and B. This is A, this is B, this is the universal set. Now for A intersection B whole complement, we will have two steps. First we have to find A intersection B. So how we can find A intersection B here? A intersection B is the common portion of A and B. So we can say that this is the common portion of A and B. Okay. So this is A intersection B. Now we move towards the second portion of this, is that is A intersection B whole complement. That is actually U minus A intersection B. It means you have to subtract this intersection portion from the whole set. Let's see how you can do that. This is the universal set. These are the two sets A and B, and this is the universal set. Now let's highlight the portion that will be included in A intersection B whole complement, as you have to subtract the common portion of A and B from the whole set. So it will include which portion? Let's highlight that portion. So this portion will be included. Now it is clearly seen that I have skipped the common portion of A and B. That will not be included in A intersection B whole complement. So this is the Venn diagram representation of A intersection B whole complement. Now we move towards the Venn diagram of A complement union B complement. So for that, first we have to find A complement, then B complement, and then we will move towards the union. So first A complement equals to U minus A will be, let's draw it. This is universal set. These are A and B. Now U minus A means you have to subtract A from the whole set. So it will be, so the portion included in A complement will be all the A has been subtracted. So we have not included the common portion of A and B as well. So after A complement, you have to find B complement, that is equals to U minus B. Now let's see how you can find that. These are the two sets. This is universal, this is A and this is B. Now B complement is U minus B. You have to subtract the B from the whole set. So B can be subtracted as just like A. So we can highlight the portion that will be included in B complement will be like this. Here again we will ignore the, or we will not include the common portion of A and B as well. Okay. Now lastly we have the union of A complement union B complement. Now let's see whether we have got the same result as A intersection B whole complement or not. So these are the two sets A and B, and this is the universal set. Now let's highlight the portion that will be included in the common of A complement and B complement. So the common portion of A complement and B complement is this all, except the common portion of A and B. That means that the intersection portion of A and B will be excluded. So it is proved that both the sides have the same Venn diagram representation. So it is clear that both the sides are same. So we can say that A intersection B, Venn diagram of A intersection B whole complement and Venn diagram of A complement union B complement is the same. So that's all about how you can draw or you can prove the Venn diagram, the De Morgan's law by using the Venn diagrams. Thank you. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.